You ready?
I'm ready.
Well, I mean, go in bloody 5 minutes. Have you seen Dana?
Go find her. You're the
director. I don't know where she is. You're...
Hello, and warm welcome to In The Loop. I'm your host, Emrite.
And I'm Dana. This week, the In The Loop cast have been out in the city scoping out what's happening right here in Birmingham.
We found out that in our very own Grand Central, there is a cafe with a catch. You can have some coffee with some cats.
We also sent off our troublesome twosome to educate you guys at home about the heritage buildings here in Brough.
Things are going to get heated in the studio with a one-on-one cocktail battle between me and Dana, which I'm obviously going to win.
You wish.
With skateboarding recently becoming an Olympic sport, we also thought we would check out some of the local competitions. So many people in Birmingham now seem to be taking up the sport, so we thought we'd have a chat and see what it's all about.
But up first, us lucky people here at The Loop have a local expert in the studio here to talk about the 3D printing business.
TechCity UK suggests a digital tech sector with the fastest growing sector in Greater Birmingham's economy over the next 5 years. It's interesting to know that the Custard Factory was the original catalyst for the Digmouth cluster and is still the largest hub of digital and creative talent outside London.
One of the fastest growing sectors is actually the 3D printing business. Many people haven't a clue what's going on with it, so our expert Josh Trevor-Smith is here to tell us all about it.
Hello, and welcome to the studio, Josh.
Hello, pleasure to be here.
So, why is it that you have brought with you today?
Behind me is a CTC 3D printer.
Would you say, could you afford it as just a listener or viewer?
Oh yeah, definitely. It's very regionally priced. It's the most reasonably priced on the market. Sorry about that.
Can you tell us why anyone would want to own a 3D printer?
Oh, you can make absolutely anything you want. Fix the house or print a few things for your kids.
Could you use this to help healthcare or important things? I mean, it's important to fit your radar and stuff, but as in further, you know, to further everything. Could you do that?
Well, yes, it's something called bioprinting, where doctors and people have actually made actual organs and hearts. Not a brain yet.
Wow, you know, that's a lot to get your head around.
Exactly that. Yeah. Rumour is, Mr. Trevor-Smith, you're going to print something for us today during the show. Any hint what's going to be on?
I'm not going to tell you anything.
Oh, come on, little clue.
Nothing.
Just
at
a little one.
You'll see.
Thank you, Mr. Trevor-Smith.
Never. We'll check back in later. And now, let's get into something a bit less complicated.
We've sent some of our team to check out the Cat Cafe in our very own Grand Central, where you can have your coffee and you can chill with some feline friends. Here they are, having a great time. Fantastic charity work being done right here in the city centre. How was your experience here at Kitty Cafe Birmingham?
I've really enjoyed it. I've not been to a Kitty Cafe before and it's nothing like I was expecting it. It's really bright and clean and lovely. I'm really enjoying it.
Is this your first time visiting here in Birmingham?
It's my first time to the Kitty Cafe. It's not the first time to Birmingham.
Have you thought about actually adopting one of the cats that you've just come down to see them?
I already have a cat who's very territorial, so I won't be doing any of that.
Oh, I know. I have three and they're nightmares. They don't like each other. Having already been tried and tested in the likes of Leeds and Nottingham, Kitty Cafes are proving to be a go-to for cat and cafe enthusiasts alike. Birmingham is very much a cat-loving city, inhabiting just over 70,000 cats according to recent statistics, so it's no wonder that Birmingham has been coined the cat capital of the UK. The funds raised here go towards care of the adorable 28 cats being facilitated inside the cafe, cats which come from a range of backgrounds such as being rescued or sadly left stray. Fantastically, all cats are looking to be rehomed. You can check them out on kittycafe.co.uk and take a look at Luna, Gizmo and the 26 other cats which could be coming home with you. We had an absolutely wonderful time here at the Kitty Cafe, so get yourself down to Grand Central Station to have a bite to eat and support this fantastic charity. We will definitely be coming back.
Oh, that sounds lovely. I think I'll be down there next time I need my next caffeine hit.
Cats running around when I'm eating? Sounds terrible. Do you know what my dinner's missing? A bit of fluff. A bit of cat hair.
You know what? I guess it's just not everyone's cup of tea.
Dana, that was worse than the cat cafe.
You know what? Talking about drinks, let's get serious about making some cocktails.
Well, you're just begging to lose, ain't you, really? Because I am the master of cocktails.
You know what? Let's just get on with it.
So let me explain the rules of the challenge. Here on the table, we have lots of ingredients to play with. Me and Diana will have 1 minute to create the most delicious cocktail out of these ingredients. And then we'll have Josh to come over and try and taste the concoction.
You know, I consider myself quite a cocktail expert, so let's get right into it.
Right. So, straight away, I'm mixing it up.
Let's go.
I'm trying something new.
I'm going to make a classic cosmopolitan.
A hot cocktail. You know, try something new. Oh, a bit of chilli sauce in there.
Right, I'm going to eat.
That's beautiful.
Two shots of vodka.
A bit of chilli powder.
Ho, ho, ho. What are you doing over there?
I'm making it fun.
A bit of peach schnapps. Ugh. Oh, God, I feel like
so
I'm
what's yours called?
Being rushed. It's called a cosmopolitan. Vodka, peach schnapps, cranberry juice, and a bit of lime.
I mean, I don't think mine has a technical name. I'll just call it...
And to finish off, a little bit of lime. Oh, God, this is a hard lime.
Lovely colour.
And then we'll shake it up. Josh, I think you should come over. Oh,
yeah. Just come over while we finish this off.
A bit of that, please.
Start knocking everything over. Spill it.
Spill it everywhere.
I think I've been by DQ.
Right.
So, what do you think so far? What's your first impression?
The
okay. Do you want to try?
I just got to make sure I decorate this so
first?
Beautifully.
No, I'll go safe.
I think you'll go for mine first.
I think we know who's going to win. Is that impressive?
Very strong. You can taste the cranberry.
Yeah,
try some more. Come on, because I feel like you're not getting the right taste.
No,
you're messing about here. A big one. Come on.
I'm okay. I don't want to get drunk.
He's got to try your taste.
Nah, you got to try the big boy. The automatic winner, because you know.
Oh, I feel bad for him.
Do you want to try this? I want to see a big gulp here, Josh. I mean, it's the best way to treat guests with cocktails. To taste these cocktails. Oh. It's going down. Oh. Is it? What? Is that no? Not a fan? Ah, who's the winner?
Who's the winner?
Dana.
Oh, do you know what? Josh, you take a seat over there, mate. We've got this.
I'm so sorry, my friend.
Now, before we kill someone else with these, let's go on to some education.
After you all demanded its return when we sent Max and Darius off to the galleries last week, we have brought back the Hood to Heritage segment for another week. This time, we thought we'd mix it up, so we've sent them off to a remote estate house on the outskirts of Burn. Let's see how they got on.
I wonder where they're sending us.
I wonder where we're going.
Let's have a look.
There might be no horror places. I don't do horror.
We're going to Highbury Hall.
Where's that?
It's in Birmingham. I love it there. You're going to love it. Trust me, come on. It's a tranquil and secluded setting in the heart of the countryside. Here you can enjoy privacy and tradition of this Grade 2 listed mansion.
Well, this is Highbury House. There's 30 acres of land on this property. This place was sculptured in 1879.
The architect was John Henry Chamberlain. Let's go inside. The architect of Highbury was renowned for his Gothic style of architecture inspired by the stones of Venice. The seminal work of John Ruskin, an Italian medieval architecture.
Pretty Gothic.
Highbury is notable for the quality of its woodwork, including inlaid and marquee ceilings and floors.
Yeah, this place is very nice, you know, I can't lie, like, I can see a lot of rich people living here. Yeah, woodwork.
bookcases were originally made for Chamberlain's study at his previous home of Southbourne in Edgbaston, which has now been demolished.
I wonder if they've got 50 Shades of Grey in there.
The Marquaying ceiling is a design of horse chestnuts and ivy leaves in walnut, elm and sycamore.
Wait, what? They've got nuts on the walls? I don't see no nuts. You see some nuts?
So what do you think of the place then?
The place is massive, man. I ain't never seen nothing like this in my whole life.
Do you like how it is? There's quite a lot of furniture, you know.
This place is massive. This place is like my whole living room and my dining room and my kitchen in one room. This place is huge. Look at the bed.
Tune in next week, or we'll be going to Birmingham Art Gallery and exploring there to see what history it has.
Well, you better tune in next week, or you're going to miss out. Peace.
See you soon.
You know, I think you'd be up for that old stuff. It's pretty interesting.
I think it'd be wasted on you, to be honest. You know what? From old to new, let's see what we've printed.
Wow, that's pretty impressive. So, Josh, want to show us?
You so jumped the gun there.
We've printed the BCU logo.
That's so impressive. Yeah. How long did this take, Josh?
Oh, just a few minutes, actually.
Wow. Well, since I can't believe you could print something like that in such a little time.
Well, since you called me stupid a minute ago, which I didn't know, no, here's a fact. Skateboarding is now going to be at the Summer Olympics. I bet you two didn't know that.
You know what, you're absolutely right. Skateboarding will make its debut appearance at the Summer Olympics in 2020 in Tokyo, Japan.
With a hot skateboarding scene here in Birmingham, we had a snoop around to get the scoop and let's see what they came back with.
Hi, Dan and Dana, Sam and Rob.
Hi.
We're here at the Croatian Skate Park Centre in Birmingham. We're here to film the Blockers Combat 2019. Today we're going to hopefully interview a couple of people and see what skateboarding means to the different generations across the UK.
Okay, hi, today I'm here with Kelly at the Skateboarding Park where we're going to start our interview. So, how long have you been doing skateboarding for?
Just over a year.
Okay, what actually got you into doing this?
I bought it, my son's up first son who's 5 years old, and I bought him a skateboard, and I suddenly thought, like, I should be quite rad if I learned to skateboard as well, then something we could do together.
Yeah, okay.
And I had my first lesson last summer, and I was absolutely obsessed.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
And what made you decide to be part of this competition?
I actually need to sort of step on a vert ramp for the first time in May this year and had a go. I met people that were part of the UK Vert Series and they encouraged me to take part in the first leg of the series, which was a skate park in Skatrim in Caterham. And oh, just the vibe, the support, the encouragement, it was just rad. I really loved it. And so yeah, I've been to all of them now and it's great.
Saying, what do you think is so appealing for skateboarders from all ages, so from young kids to older people to young people like you?
So, in my opinion, so all the older guys just follow the skateboard when they were younger, they probably all the kids and got them into it, but it's more just like the fact that there's so many different tricks and styles you can skate on vert, on street, on bowl, so it appeals to so many different kinds of people, no matter what their style is or like that, so yeah.
Yeah,
anyone from old to young.
And you feeling confident for the competition?
10%.
Well, good luck and thanks very much for having
us. Hi everyone, we're here at the Croatian Skate Park and it was a crazy competition.
It was really good.
It was,
very
exactly.
Yeah.
Most of these young guys were doing great and me and Sam actually thought we should put our skills to the test.
So we went down to Digbeth and had a go at it and it didn't turn out as well as we thought, but
this is how it turned out. Hello everyone, last week we've been to skateboarding competition and now we're here to try our own skills to the battle and see how we get on.
If you're gonna be dumb, you gotta be tough. When you get knocked down, you gotta get back up. I ain't the sharpest knife in the drawer, but I know enough to know. If you're gonna be dumb, you gotta be tough.
I bet I could do a kickflip.
Please don't do that if you value your face.
Well, I'll get Mr. Trendsmith to print me a new nose, so definitely.
You know what, that's perfect timing. That's all we have here, have all the time we have for on the show right now.
So anyway, tune in next week when we're broadcasting from the Birmingham Christmas Market and we're keeping you up to date with all events this Christmas.
Yeah, to play you out, we have been very lucky and we have an up and coming band here today all the way from Digbeth.
And that's far.
Yeah, it is. Let's welcome Ethan and Alessandra. See you next week.
For too long with no love or anything. I still remember the taste of your lipstick and perfume and you're still in my brain. Even though now I'm insane, I can't come back. I'm out of love, I'm out of taste, I'm out of touch. I don't want much, you're just a little love, just a little love to keep me going for now. Just a little.